We are going to start passing out some awards now, and the first two people to do that are truly institutions here in Chicago television. Each one of them has received the coveted Governor's Award at last year's Emmy show for their long-term excellence. These people were stars in 1958 when I was chasing Red Quinlan down the halls at WBKB yelling, "What do I do now?" She is from Channel 2 Newsbreak. He is from Channel 7's Eyewitness News. Here are Lee Phillip and Fahey Flynn.
Thank you, Bob. Haven't changed a bit. Well, Lee, you're more beautiful than ever.
Oh, thank you. Certainly we've gone through all kinds of fun and excitement in the last 20 years, haven't we, Fahey?
We sure have.
Can you remember some things that you'd like
to
say?
Yes, I remember you when you first...
I'm so glad.
I remember you when you first came into the business.
Did you?
And you used to wear your hair in a...
And a braid?
A braid,
yeah. Oh, all right. Well, I remember you when you wore a straight tie and used to say, "What's the outlook, PJ?"
Well, you don't really talk about that anymore. Well,
the outlook might read be there.
Yes, it could be.
All right.
We have the nominees in our first category, 1A, for outstanding achievement within a regularly scheduled news program, Investigative Reporting. They are Soldier Field Rock Concert Investigation, Jim Ruddle Reporter, Chuck Collins Reporter-Producer, Channel 11. A Working Mother's Nightmare, Seven on Your Side, Rona Douglas Reporter, Susan McIntosh Producer, Channel 7. Tees and Blues, Peter Carl Reporter, Don Barryu, Mike Sullivan Co-Producers, Channel 7. Humboldt Park, Christopher Chandler, Brian Boyer, Don Johnson Co-Producers, Channel 2. Buying Baby, Susan Anderson Reporter, Channel 2. Newman Death, Jim Cummins, reporter-producer, Channel 5. Goldblatt's, Russ Ewing, reporter, Arasucho, producer, Channel 5. Lee?
That is a very competitive category, and the first award will go to, let's pull out the card, Soldier Field Rock Concert Investigation, Jim Ruddle, reporter, Chuck Collins, reporter-producer, WTTW.
Well, thank you very much, and I'd also like to thank Channel 11. They were brave enough to give me 5.5 months full-time to work on the story, and without that type of concern from the management, I don't think we ever could have done it. I'd also like to thank Jim, our crew, Emmett Wilson, Bosco Lindbergh, and Maurice Smith. Thank you very much.
As Chuck indicated, he did all the work. I just came along and said some words. Thank you.
These are photocopies of tickets you sold. That BX designated tickets. Are you aware that's a violation of the rules of Ticketron? Mr. Newberg is already aware of it. Where does the money go for the 65-cent service charge on the BX tickets, Mr. Casson?
Sir, I don't care to answer any more questions at this time.
Is this your idea, Mr. Casson, or do you have help?
Sir, I do not wish to answer any more questions at this time.
Have you been speaking with your attorney?
The nominees in Category 1B, Outstanding Achievements Within the Regularly Scheduled News Program Spot Coverage, are Resignation of James Rochford, Jim Ruddle, Chuck Collins, Christine Harris, Andrew Siegel, and Joel Weissman, Reporting Team, Channel 11. Children Saved, Rona Douglas, Reporter, Channel 7. Hostages, Hugh Hill, Frank Mathy, Jay Levine, Reporting Team, Channel 7. The Memo That Shook City Hall, Walter Jacobson, Reporter, Channel 2. Humboldt Park Riots, Dick Kay, Bonnie DeVries, Rich Samuels, Jim Cummins, Rich Newberg, Don Craig, Reporting Team, Channel 5. Fahey, this one is for you to open.
All right.
Another exciting award.
And the winner Humboldt Park riots. Dick Kay, Donnie DeVries, Nick Sanders, Jim Cummins, Mitch Stewart, and Donna Flynn.
Thank you very much, and I want to extend a special thank you to Paul Beavers and to my wife Connie and my kids for putting up with the ridiculous demands of this business. When I got called out in the middle of the night last summer to cover these riots, they got bothered too. Thank you.
I would like to offer the same thanks to my wife Carolyn, my son Nick, and also to the people that helped me in the street that day, Jim Coglanese, Neil Flagg, and John Cisniewski.
And I'd like to thank the people in the field who really did all the work.
Congratulations. Thank you. I'd like to thank Jim Strickland in particular, who was with me when the riots broke out. He was the cameraman. He was wonderful. Thank you, Jim.
I would like to say, as a medium, we are great in covering explosions, but it's the fuses now we have to follow. Thank you.
I'd like to say thank you very much to Jim Strickland and Randy Birch, and especially Randy Birch, who almost got killed that night, to Eddie Banks, who had a knife stuck in his back, and to all of the people who made this possible. And also, I'm not sure I want to thank the assignment editor who called me in when the riot broke out, but to the people in the Puerto Rican community, I'd like to say, let's just hope that this is a reminder that you're not forgotten. Thank you very much.
There were about 100 people around at this point pushing this police car, and behind them cheering them on, screaming and yelling. The car was empty. Then they set the police car on fire, knocked all the windows out, and it completely went up into flames, and we thought it was going to explode. We were about a half block away, and our long lens got this shot that you're seeing now. Then the same crowd ran back across the park, and here you see them. They set a police paddy wagon on fire, and then they turned their efforts to this unmarked police car that you see now. And they began throwing bricks, throwing rocks, beating all the windows in of the car, screaming and yelling. By this time, the police had backed off from this area.
Well, I'm not going to do any jokes after that. Moving ahead with the 20th anniversary Emmy show, it's time to turn around and look back. Chicago has been blessed with many talented television performers, and sooner or later, most of them ended up giving or getting Emmys on previous shows like this one. We've rounded up as many old Emmy shows as we could find, and here's a look at some of the faces.
Seems like making dreams come true, doing things we used to do, seems like old times, being here with you. Doesn't seem like it used to be, having you to walk with. It's exactly like old, old
time. This, monitors are up here, in case you're wondering why I keep looking at this ceiling. This must be a form of Shangri-La, because none of the people have gotten any older. Our next presenter was a founder and the first president of the Chicago Academy, and over the years, he has taken a lot of Emmys home. Unfortunately, none of them were his. From Channel 11, the man with the longest-running talk show in the world, Mr. Chicago, Mr. Irv Kupcinet.
Thank you, Robert. We in the Academy are so proud of Robert Newhart because, as you heard the story, that he made it starting here 20 years ago, and he comes back here 20 years later, and we're really indebted to him because Bob works very cheap. He comes here free. Ladies and gentlemen, it's my pleasure to announce the category 1C Outstanding Achievement within a regularly scheduled news program, : feature stories or miniseries, and they are The Mexican Connection, Jay Levine, reporter-producer, Channel 7. Childbirth, Jay Levine, reporter, Elizabeth Richter, producer, Channel 7. The Kenya Massacre, Bill Kurtis, reporter, Donna LaPietra, producer, Channel 2. Return to Cuba, Chuck Gomez, reporter-producer, Channel 2. Nazis, Jim Cummings, reporter-producer, Channel 5. And the Heart Bypass Operation, Barry Kaufman, reporter, Roger Sergal, producer, Channel 5. And the winner, The Kenya Massacre, Bill Kurtis, reporter, Donna LaPietra, producer, WTTW.
Thank you so much. First of all, I have to thank our editor, Steve Stribling, who did a wonderful job. Second of all, I have to thank the Channel 2 Newsroom for being such a great place for me to learn about television journalism, and to thank it for one of its teachers, Bill Kurtis, who has taught me, and I'm sure many, many of us, so many things about the business of hard news. And last of all, to Scott and Mary Kristen, who share their daddy with so many people. Thank you.
And to Peter Bertolini, who's on a minicam somewhere around here, and Chuck Meyer, who kept us all together when we were an hour north of Nairobi and thought everything was going to go haywire and did, and to my dad, who was along on the ride, too. Thanks.
Now, the people at this mission, it's a skeleton staff, are trying to take care of them. The more severe cases will be flown out on the plane that we came in. This is an intertribal rivalry. Bandits who came in trying to steal goats. There are no politics here, but you can see the primitive situation. There, a doctor, one of the two that is on hand, just happened to be in the area, flying again with Africa Inland Mission, carrying a young child. And this gets down to the basics. Most of the wounds are knife wounds and spear wounds, although there were a few guns that were involved.
We'll return to the 20th Annual Chicago Emmy Awards in just a moment.
A customer's car kept running on after he turned off the key. So he brought the car in for a tune-up. But this baby doesn't need a tune-up. Amoco Premium Lead Free is made to stop engine run-on. If your car's in tune but still runs on, it doesn't need engine work. It needs higher octane fuel like Amoco Premium Lead Free. And if it doesn't have performance problems, use the Midwest's best-selling Lead Free in the Blue Pump. After all, you expect more from a leader.
Because lawns come in so many shapes and sizes, so do Lawn Chief mowers from True Value Hardware Stores. Like this 20-inch mulching mower that eliminates bagging and raking by turning grass clippings into lawn food. And this easy-to-handle self-propelled mower that's ideal for large lawns. Or choose a 21-inch self-propelled rear bagger designed to maneuver in narrow places and trim close on three sides. You'll find a Lawn Chief mower to match your lawn exclusively at participating True Value Hardware stores.
What this country needs is a good pair of $7 sandals. Introducing new Fava June Bugs. Cool summer wedges for a very cool $7. Choose beige or navy canvas or white with a cork wedge. Only $7. So how can you buy only one pair? Fava June Bugs for little girls are $5. And June Bugs handbags are just $4. Spend your summer in Fava June Bugs. You'll have a lot more to spend on everything else.
We've got a great day for you, 'cause there's so much to do at Marriott's Great America.
Great America's open daily all week long from 10 to 10. Now you can have a great day every day.
At Marriott's Great America.